fatless sponge. All cakes are divided into two categories. One is the shortened category and the other is the egg foam category or the low fat category. Today I am going to show you one method in the egg foam category or the low foam category, low fat category, and that is called the sponge method. There are two other methods also. One is the chiffon method and the other one is the angel food method. Now I will start with the egg foam method. I will just show you the ingredients and then we go on to the method. Okay, now we go to the ingredients. Now here this is 115 grams of refined flour. Then we have 115 grams of grain sugar. Here if you can see properly. Then there are 3 eggs here. Can you see the eggs? Yes, great. Now this is baking powder. We are going to add a quarter teaspoon of baking powder to the flour. And then we are going to sieve it later on. This is vanilla essence. You may add any essence of your choice. For example, if you are going to make a gato with pineapple, you can add pineapple essence. If it's a mango gato, you can add mango essence. Today we are just making a plain cake, so I'm going to add only vanilla essence. Okay, now we will have a look at the tools and equipment which is needed to prepare this cake. First and foremost, we need a 1/2 kilo cake tin. This is a 1/2 kilo cake tin, and I have cut paper for the side and for the base. Okay, this is a circle and a side strip. I will require some melted fat so that I can apply it on the sides so that the greaseproof paper sticks to the tin. I am going to use a brush to apply the melted fat. Now you will be wondering, what is this? Now in this I am going to place hot water so that on top of that I am going to keep this bowl in which I am going to beat the eggs and the sugar. Then we have 2 egg beaters here. We can also use an electric hand mixer, but today I will be using 2 egg beaters to make my work fast. Then we have a spatula to mix the flour into our egg foam. Then we have a set of measuring spoons to measure our baking powder. And last but not the least, we have a soup strainer on where I am going to sieve the flour over the egg foam, and then I'm going to mix it with a spatula. Okay, now what we are going to do is we are going to grease this cake tin. We are going to use a brush. Today we are using melted fat, but you can also use oil. Any oil can be used to grease the tin. Any oil, I just mentioned any oil except peanut oil. Okay, don't use peanut oil. Any other oil can be used. Okay, after that what we are going to do is we are going to put the side strip first. It is very important that we put the side strip first and then we put the circle, the base. Do not bend the greaseproof paper at the base, okay? The extra bit we will just tear it off, okay? No bending the paper at the base. After that, once this is put, let's see that it is placed properly, and then we take this circle and we put it at the base. Now this is an important step. If we don't do this properly, what's going to happen is when you put the batter, then sometimes this side strip gets into the batter and while demolding your cake might just break. So therefore, greasing and putting the GP paper is a very important step. This is what we are doing. Now this is done. Our tin is ready. Now we will start breaking the eggs. Is it clear? Actually start with the process of making the fatless sponge. We have 115 grams of sugar here. I am going to add the sugar. This is, I told you, grain sugar, which is going to give us an open texture. And then I am going to break 3 eggs. Okay. So pick up the egg and break it. Yeah, I'm sure all of you know by now that all the ingredients have to be at room temperature. Okay, so all these ingredients are at room temperature. Yeah. The eggs are washed and kept. The
These are fresh eggs. That's why I can break it directly into the sugar. If they are slightly old, you break it separately and then you start adding one by one. Now never keep this mixture like this and you go and do some other work. Always see that you mix this right away. Otherwise what's going to happen is that the yolk, the sugar is hygroscopic. So therefore it will start absorbing all the water from the egg yolk and the egg yolks will become dry. So it is very important that you immediately start beating the eggs and the sugar. After that what I am going to do is I am going to take hot water and pour it in the tin. Use sufficient water, but the water should not touch the vessel, only the steam has to touch the base of the vessel. Start beating the eggs and the sugar and take it over the hot water. Keep the same speed throughout. Okay, now I think I'm going to stop beating the egg and sugar. I'm going to take it off the hot water. What I'm going to do is I'm going to pick up this bowl and keep it on the side. And I am going to remove the egg beater. Now I'm going to make use of my spatula. First, clean the sides. It's very important that we clean the sides of the bowl. Then I'm going to take some hot water. I'm going to add about 4 tablespoons of hot water to get the consistency right. So this is 1 tablespoon is 15 ml. This is 30. Then this is 45 and this is 60. After that I'm also going to add essence here. I've not added essence. Never add essence in the beginning because it's a water-based essence. Vanilla essence is a water-based essence. The other essences are oil-based essence. And both water and oil will hamper the beating of the eggs. Now I have to mix the whole mixture in such a way that I don't deflate this mixture. I'm going to just fold in very lightly. First, I'm going to mix the water. The water is going to go and settle at the bottom of the vessel. So therefore I just mix the water with the egg and sugar mixture. This is how I am going to do it. And then I am going to take the sieve and I am going to sieve the refined flour and baking powder which I have already added to this mixture. Here I go. I just sieve everything on top of the egg and sugar mixture. You can sieve it and keep and add. You can do this way also, or you can sieve and keep it ready and then add it to the egg and sugar mixture. This is how you go. This is done and then you just mix it very lightly. You have to be quick, at the same time no vigorous movements. Clean the sides, keep cleaning the sides. Push the flour which has gone right at the base, because flour being heavy it will go and settle at the base. So push the mixture from the base with the help of a spatula. This is how you go. You kind of shove it up. Okay. The mixture is, the flour has got mixed properly now. Now do not over mix. Now it's time to put it in the cake tin. So the mixture is ready. Now what we do is we will just put it in our cake tin. So you place the cake tin here and you pour the cake batter. Can you see? There are no lumps. The flour has got mixed properly. And now, sometimes you might see a lump of flour there. Don't try to kind of break it or anything. You can just put it in the batter and bake it. Because if you go on trying to break those lumps, you are basically deflating the whole mixture and the cake might not turn out the way we want it to turn out. Now, After you have put most of the batter, then what you are going to do is you are going to clean the vessel. No wastage. Now whatever is here, little bit, don't put it in the center. Try and put it on the side of the cake thing. If you see carefully, you will find there's a difference in color, because this, the air has escaped and therefore the color is slightly darker than the mixture which was put initially. You are not going to spread it out, you are not going to do anything, you are not going to bang the cake tin, nothing. Just put it directly for baking in a preheated oven.
Cake batter is ready, we have put it in the tin. What we are going to do is we are going to bake it in a preheated oven at 200 degrees centigrade for about 20 to 25 minutes till it acquires a nice color and a spongy texture. Some more time and then you can cut it and prepare the